During a volcanic eruption, one spectacular sight to witness is where a flow of fairly fluid lava rapidly increases its speed as it accelerates down a steep slope, like seen during the 2021 eruption of the Fagradalsfjall volcano in Iceland. However, what is even better to witness is when that same lava flow is rapidly pulled down by the force of gravity over a sheer 90-degree cliff where it falls down to Earth much like a waterfall. What I'm referring to are called lava falls, which in historic times at Kilauea have been measured to be up to 140 meters or 460 feet in height. Yet, if we go back further in time to about 73,000 years ago in the Grand Canyon, there was once a 1,000 meter or 3,280 foot high lava fall from the eruption of Vulcan's Throne, which went on to temporarily dam a section of the Colorado River. While both of these examples are spectacular, if we want to find where the largest known lava fall occurred, we have to look outside of Earth. Options with traditional volcanism include Mars, which hasn't produced a volcanic eruption in 50,000 years, Venus, which last produced a documented eruption in 1993, or the solar system's most volcanically active world, the sulfur-covered moon of Jupiter known as Io. Io has more than 150 active volcanoes, with multiple volcanoes which are erupting right now. One such recent eruption, for example, created a vast 200-kilometer or 124-mile-wide lava lake. As for the largest lava fall on Io, it occurred in 1997. There, at the several-kilometer-high Pillan Patera volcano, a massive flood basalt eruption caused molten rock erupted at the top of a caldera along a fissure to fall back into the caldera, which had a depth of approximately 10,000 feet. This caldera measured 70 kilometers across, being a little more than 15 times wider than the Kilauea volcano's caldera in Hawaii. The Pillan Patera volcano's eruption began with a bang via a series of explosions that occurred as the surface sulfur dioxide frost flashed through a gas due to the heat of nearby magma, generating explosions. These explosions were quite large, as there was only 18.3% the gravity that exists on Earth and an almost non-existent atmosphere, which would have otherwise confined an explosion to a set size. As lava erupted along a 50-kilometer-long fissure at multiple points, numerous 3,500-meter-tall lava fountains were generated. Simultaneously, a plume of ash was sent 150 kilometers into the sky, spreading out over an area the size of Arizona. This region that spanned 400 kilometers or 248 miles across would soon be coated in a black layer of fresh ash. At the initial phase of the eruption, lava was being emitted at a rate of perhaps as much as 500,000 cubic meters per second, dwarfing even the peak eruptive rate of long-extinct flood basalts on Earth. Lava quickly piled up near the eruptive vents, where it solidified in the very cold negative 210 degrees Fahrenheit temperatures. As more material erupted at a reduced rate, the lava crept closer and closer to the northeast section of the 10,000-foot-deep caldera rim. Eventually going into it, a single giant lava fall was generated, where it took 58.3 seconds for falling lava to reach the bottom. When it impacted the caldera bottom, lava was traveling at a speed of 376.8 kilometers per hour, which was sufficient enough to carve away at sections of the floor it impacted, much like a raging waterfall on Earth does. Two additional lava lobes eventually reached nearby sections of the caldera, causing a series of lava falls to be continuous for several months. By the time the eruption ended, the entire caldera floor had been covered in a layer of lava, as fresh molten rock from this eruption covered 5,500 square kilometers. In total, 56 cubic kilometers of magma had erupted. The reason why Io has so many volcanoes is almost completely caused by tidal heating. In other words, as Io orbits around Jupiter in a slightly variable orbit, the gravitational pull of Jupiter and three other large moons pull on Io at differing intensities. This causes Io to stretch by as much as 100 meters or 330 feet every day, which creates an immense amount of friction that generates heat in the planet's upper mantle. This causes rock to melt and generates abundant volcanic eruptions. Thanks for watching. If you would like to request a specific topic, please leave a comment below. Additionally, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.